Hello, and welcome to Lecture 3 of the Human Energy Use Topic Unit in PHYS 2104. As I said in Lecture 1, we should not only consider the supply or production of energy by humans, but also the demand or consumption. But we're going to leave that until the next topic unit on environmental impacts. For the remainder of the lectures in this unit, we're going to look at the different ways that we produce power. And in this lecture, we're going to focus on what is currently the dominant way, which is fossil fuels. One thing we need to discuss with any source of primary energy is the available supply. Now, in the case of coal, the available supply is huge, and we're not about to run out of it anytime soon. Where much of the discussion in recent years has been is over the supply of oil, and so we're going to start there by looking at proven reserves. So we're going to start by looking at this graph of world proven reserves of oil over the last 40 years or so. And what may immediately be occurring to you as a question if you're not used to thinking about this is, how can the proven reserves be increasing? After all, we are consuming oil, and it might be even more puzzling to you if you happen to know that most of the major reserves of oil were discovered by the 1960s, and more recent discoveries have been comparatively small. So, how on earth can the proven reserves be increasing? And this comes down to understanding what's actually meant by the term proven reserve. The first thing to realize is that proven reserve is not the same as oil in the ground. Absolutely, we are pumping oil out of the ground at quite a high rate. The actual quantity of oil in the ground has to be decreasing. What proven reserve really means is the amount of known recoverable oil, and recoverable under assumptions of current technology, economics, and what the regulations are. When a geological survey discovers some volume of oil in the ground, that whole volume is not part of the proven reserves. Only a fraction of it is, and that is the fraction that is known to be recoverable in a profitable manner. That fraction may grow over time as technology improves. It would also grow if the price of oil goes up. And so overall, the proven reserves are a complicated intersection of geology, engineering, economics, business, and politics. This point is, I think, well illustrated by looking at this graph of the proven oil reserves just for Canada over the last 40 years, and notice this enormous jump in 1998, where the proven reserves more than tripled. Why is this? Was there some previously unknown supply of oil in Canada discovered in 1998? You can even see this jump on the global supply. Well, no, this was not a new supply that was discovered. This was the reclassification of the oil sands as part of the proven reserves because of technological advances and higher oil prices, and so it was judged that the oil sands could now be economically competitive. But note that this is a judgment call on when it became economically competitive. This particular graph comes from BP Stats Review, but if you look at the US Energy Information Administration, they'll show a similar jump in 2003, not in 1998. So now that we understand a little bit more about oil reserves, let's try to talk about the question everybody would like an answer to, which is, are we running out of oil? Or, as this is often phrased, when will peak oil happen? And to start with, we actually have to realize that proven reserves are not what we need to look at. Suppose proven reserves started to decline tomorrow. That's not what's meant by peak oil. That would technically be what we would call depletion. What people mean when they talk about peak oil is the peak in world oil production. That's what we would mean by peak oil. Now, depletion and peak oil are very likely to be connected, and one could well bring about the other one, but these are both as likely to be brought about by economic and political factors as they are by reductions in the supply of oil in the ground. For an example of this, just look at the fact that peak oil has already actually happened once in the past, in 1979, and it was caused by war, high prices, and fuel economy standards for cars. But let's set all that complexity aside for a moment and just look at some raw numbers to try and get our heads around the scale of all of this. Right now, world-proven reserves stand at about 1.7 times 10 to the 12 barrels, and world oil production is about 3.5 times 10 to the 10 barrels per year. If you just divide the one by the other, you come up with a figure of about 50 years. But realize that that's treating this as if it was a tank of a fixed capacity being drained at a fixed rate, which it absolutely isn't. In particular, note that the rate of increase of world-proven reserves, and note that's after we already deduct production, is faster than the rate of oil production. That tells you that new oil is added to proven reserves at a rate of over twice the rate of oil production. So, we can give an overly simplistic answer with many, many caveats that no, we're not running out of oil anytime very soon. So let's check your understanding of these admittedly rather complex issues. So this graph is taken from a source from BP, and it shows projections of world consumption after 2020. Note that this is showing consumption, not production. But if supply roughly follows demand, then this is saying that people at BP think we're already at or near peak oil. Now, I'm not asking whether you believe these projections. In particular, notice if you look at the past data and project forward, would you come up with curves that look like this? But that aside, what do you suppose the primary reason would be for the analysts at BP to think this? Is this due to depletion of oil reservoirs in the ground, reduced demand driven by various things, or reduced supply because oil companies voluntarily decide to produce less?